lecturer of today. Thank you very much, sir. May I invite the Vice Chancellor to come take the next assignment? The Vice Chancellor, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, you will agree with me that has been a very educative and stimulating lecture. Please, another round of applause for the lecturer of the day. Please join me rise as I invite the Chancellor and Chairman Board of Regents Covenant University, ably represented by the Education Secretary Living Faith Church Worldwide, for his remarks. Chancellor, sir.
My case is different. Please, shall we be seated? It's indeed a great privilege to be able to stand in for the Chancellor, who is unavoidably absent. He has asked me to tender his unreserved apology and to say that he's here in spirit with us. First, I think we need to give God the glory, the appreciation for giving us this day. And, you know, we had showers of blessings to start off the lecture. He has done all things well. We thank God. I want to appreciate the Vice Chancellor and the Senate, all principal officers of the university, and most especially to congratulate our inaugural lecturer of today. You'll agree with me that was a well thought out lecture, well researched, well thought out, with data, research findings. I pray that God will increase your grace. I was following as he was delivering the lecture. This is an active researcher who has researched not only in around the catchment area of Covenant University, but also in Ibadan, Ile-Ife, Badagry in Lagos, even southeast in Ebonyi. And maybe the next round of research would be, why were many people from Ebonyi State traders? I happen to know by exposure that is the least developed state in the southeast. Maybe the poorest. The statistics may have changed. With due respect to those who may come from Ebonyi, they were the ones supplying ourselves to the other part of the southeast and beyond. But the metrics may have changed. I thoroughly enjoyed the research, and I have pertinent things to take away for the Chancellor, one of which is the proposed in his recommendation. Is proposing a partnership, Covenant University partnership, with this informal sector to grow employment. Definitely that will get back to the Chancellor. I also noted when he said that government or the formal sector is so hostile. Hostile to the informal sector. I have witnessed this, and I believe that some of us may have witnessed it too. Harassment. Before you know, an agency of government is there and they are carrying okada, they are carrying their wares, you know, sometimes they bundle them into their truck. I hope that there will be a paradigm shift at Student Change, because we know that the only reason that the Nigerian economy has not collapsed is because of this informal sector. The only reason, you know, those of us who are in paid employment, we know how many dependents we support informally. We know how many we support informally. If you are blessed that you have a child abroad, you know how many get their sustenance through that means or modality. So that's the only reason I believe the Nigerian economy, despite the pilfering, the assault on our commonwealth, our national treasury, stealing here, left, right, and center, not only by politicians, but by government officials, public officials, let me say. The only reason that economy is still standing is because of the informal sector. So definitely, it is a good, you know, idea to want to look at how we can empower that sector such that it can do more. You know that many people, especially bank workers, when they get laid off, the first thing they do is they put their cars to commuting business, cab hire, car, you know. So the only reason that the economy has not crashed, like we have in some developed economies in Europe a few years back, is because of the informal sector. I don't want to reenact what he has said. All I have come to say is that I believe all of us did. I thoroughly enjoyed the lecture. There are a lot of, you know, pertinent points that he has raised that we definitely get back to the Chancellor. I want to thank you all for your patience in following the course of this lecture. And I believe that as I have benefited, we all have benefited. I want to pray that God will continue to uphold Covenant University. I would not end the address, short speech, without congratulating the Chancellor and the entire Senate, principal officers, on the feat that Covenant University is making. Recently, I think it was last Sunday, we read it in the broadcast, what God is doing in Covenant University. And 2022 is still how many years away? See, if God says it, you can go to sleep. Because he's not a man. If he says this, he will do it. So I want to say more grace to your elbow. And on that note, I think I should try and wind down. I want to thank you again. The family of the professor, the madam, and the representative of the children, thank you for giving him peace at home, to be able to focus, to give us this wonderful presentation. The Lord bless you, Ma. Thank you, and God bless you.
That's the representative of the Chancellor of Covenant University. One more time, come put us together for her. Just before we take our seats, at this point, the representative of the Chancellor would like to take her leave. While we remain standing, can we just remain standing as we allow her to take her leave? One more time, let's put hands together for her as she takes her leave. Thank you very much, ma'am. You may please be seated. The lecture of today has been by the grace of God, and I remember at the inception when we had the citation of the guest lecturer, one of the things we heard was that he is a teacher who teaches people and builds them. I'm privileged to be one of those that Professor Olurinola, the lecturer of today, taught, and I've been a student since 2300 level here in Covenant University, and was my supervisor at the master's level as well as at the PhD level. And so there are many people like me here trained. Once again, we deeply appreciate your efforts, and God bless you richly in Jesus' name. It's good for us to acknowledge God for what we've seen today, and also appreciate a couple of persons who have been instrumental in making today wonderful. To take that, I would like us to welcome Dr. Evans Osabunhe, the head of Department of Economics, to take the vote of thanks for this lecture. Let's put hands together for him as he comes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Chancellor, sir, please presented. I count myself highly privileged to be asked to move this vote of thanks on this august occasion. I say I'm very, very grateful. Thank you, sir. Now, first and foremost, we'd like to give God all the glory, because all wisdom and all knowledge comes from Him. We thank you for making today a great success. We say may His name be praised in Jesus' mighty name. On behalf of the university community, let's appreciate our Chancellor and the Chairman of the Board of Regents here represented today, as we have seen, for giving us direction as a university. We say may God increase His anointing in Jesus' mighty name. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as you may know, Inaugural Lecture series has become a grand tradition for this university, whereby our professors are given the platform to showcase to the world their groundbreaking and innovative research, as I've seen today. So no doubt, I know, as I've seen, that today's lecture has been highly stimulating and nourishing. So on this note, I wish to appreciate the guest lecturer of today. And interestingly, some 14 years ago, he was my HOD, and about 13 years ago, he was my master's thesis supervisor. Thank you so much, sir, for being a wonderful leader, a mentor, a father, and a friend. And as I said, behind every successful man is a woman. So I want to appreciate the family members, the wife, and the children. Say thank you so much for helping him through and supporting him through all this while. God bless you so much. We'd like to as well appreciate the Covenant University management team led by our own award-winning Vice Chancellor. Thank you so much, sir. And all the erudite professors, Senate members, faculty members, and our kings and queens in Hebron. Thank you so much. God bless you and grant you safe journeys back home to your various destinations. Thank you all, and God bless.
One more time, let's put us together for him. We are rounding off this session, and we'll be doing that, first of all, by having the announcement. And the announcement is simple. Immediately after we are done here, we are going to be having a cocktail at the Center for Learning Resources. But this is for members of Senate and our invited guests. We'll flash the remaining to you by email to the students. I would like the band to also get ready so that immediately after the closing prayer, we'll have the band take it off from there. We are going to be having the procession immediately after the band is done leading us, and we're going to be going through the love entrance. It's going to be in the reverse order. The Vice Chancellor is going to lead in that procession, and we're going to be going through the love entrance. At this point, permit me to invite the Chancellor of Covenant, the Chaplain, sorry, Covenant University, as he leads us in the closing prayer.
Please, let's rise up. Let's rise up, please. Shall we pray? Father, we want to appreciate you. You were our Alpha, and now you are our Omega, the beginning and the end. Thank you, Almighty God, for the successful presentations. Thank you, Almighty God, for the great weather you've given us. Thank you, Almighty God, for the orderliness, the serenity in the environment. We give you all the praise. Thank you, Almighty God, for the knowledge that has been shared with every one of us today. We trust you, Lord Jesus, that this knowledge shared today will be converted from knowledge to reality, and to testimony in this nation in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. What we have done here today will also be part of those treasures moving Covenant University forward in the mighty name of Jesus. You have been with the lecturer of today. We ask Almighty God that you will replenish him. You will be with his family in the name of Jesus Christ. And everyone that has traveled from far and near, we ask Almighty God, as you brought them here safely, you will take them back home safely in the name of Jesus. And at the end of it all, Almighty God, your name alone will be glorified and you will cause our joy to be full. Thank you, Father. Take all the glory. In Jesus' great name, we have prayed. Amen.
Session in the reverse order. Of Senate. Students, you can remain standing as we allow our invited guests. Thank you.